everyone and welcome back to the Science Hub. In today's presentation, we are going to learn about hair structure and hair cycle. Hair, it is located deep in the dermis and open up onto the surface of epidermis. Hair is produced in a follicle. So now let's learn about the hair follicle. Follicles are formed during the growth of the fetus. No new follicles are formed postnatally, that refers to after birth. Hair with its follicle attached is a good source of DNA, which can be further included for the forensic importance too. Follicle development is initiated in the fetus at different times depending on the region. General hair development begins starting with the forehead and scalp at about 4th fetal month and continues through 5th month. As the skin of the fetus expands with growth, new follicles form between the original primary ones. Development of the sebaceous gland, that is the secreting gland which secretes the lubricating material for the hair, it takes place in the 6th month. New follicles do not develop to any great extent after birth and with the further skin expansions. The fetal follicle distribution pattern tends to be lost, creating more random arrangement of hair usually seen for the human scalp hair. The hair follicle serve as a reservoir for epithelial and the melanocyte stem cells. Structure of hair follicle or the structure of complete hair. Here from the beginning we can see the portion hair shaft here is indicating. It is a part of hair that we can see on the surface of the skin. Then erector pili muscle, which are the smooth muscles and active for the goosebumps and kind of effects. Hair follicle, from which the hair grows. Then sebaceous gland, it is a secreting gland which secretes the lubricating material for the hair. Then hair root, where the hair follicle is embedded. Then hair follicle receptors, it is used to send and receive the nerve impulses when the hair moves. Then adipose tissue, it stores the fat. And last is the sensory nerve fiber. And on the other hand, we can see the three layers, that is epidermis, dermis and hypodermis. Epidermis, it is the outermost layer. Below the epidermis, there is dermis, which is a thick layer of a living tissue. And after that, at the last is the hypodermis, and it is mainly used to store the fats. Then eukrine sweat gland, which is a major sweat gland of a human body. Then Pacinian corpuscles, which are encapsulated ending of the sensory nerve that act as a receptor for the pressure and vibration. And last one is the cutaneous vascular plexus. Hair growth cycle. The division, differentiation and migration of the cells occur in various tissues of hair follicle. The process gives rise to growth of the hair fiber. It is not a continuous process but one which ceases periodically and then starts again. It is not a continuous process, or we can say it is a periodically process, which in the half end it will start, and after the full growth is occurred it will cease, and then again after some time it will start again to be repeated in what it is termed as the hair growth cycle. The human head hair grows at the rate of approximately 0.3 mm per day. Hair development is a continuous cyclic process, and all mature follicles go through a growth cycle consisting of growth, that is anagen phase, other is regression, catagen phase, rest phase, that is telogen, and last one is the shedding or the exogen phase. The duration of phases changes based on the location of the hair and also personal, nutritional and hormonal status of a particular person. Life of hair cycle, which includes the three phase, that is anagen, catagen phase and telogen phase. Anagen phase is the phase where hair is actively growing, and we can say that it is 2 to 6 years. And the second is the catagen phase, in which the hair has stopped growing and it stays for 3 weeks. And last is the telogen phase, in which it stays for 3 months and hair prepared to shed. First phase, anagen or the active growth phase. The growing phase of hair is called the anagen phase. The hair follicle enlarges and takes the original shape. As the hair grows, it pushes towards the surface of the skin and becomes longer. By the time a hair approaches the skin surface, cell death occurs at the medulla, cortex and cuticle. Hair shaft synthesis and pigmentation takes place only in anagen. At the end of anagen, mitotic activity of cell is diminished. अब anagen phase में क्या होता है, तो एक active growing phase है hair का, और इस phase के time क्या होगा, जो hair follicle होगा, here we can see, it enlarges और जो उसके original shape में आ जाएगा, और उसके बाद जो hair growth होगा उसमें से, और उसको बाहर की तरफ, ये मतलब outer screen की तरफ push करेगा, और by the time वो एक hair का shape ले लेगा, और उसके बाद जो भी मतलब जो सिंथेसिस हो रहा है या फिर पिगमेंटेशन हो रहा है, वो एनाजन फेज के टाइम ही कंसिडर हो जाएगा पूरा. कैटाजन फेज, एट द एंड ऑफ एनाजन फेज सेल एंटर द कैटाजन फेज एंड द फॉलिकल ऑल्सो नोन एज अ क्लब हेयर बिकम्स इनएक्टिव. द फॉलिकल बिकम्स स्मॉलर एंड बिकम्स डी अटैच फ्रॉम द हेयर रूट. कैटाजन में क्या होगा कि जो सेल्स, जैसे ही एनाजन फेज कंप्लीट होगा, सेल्स होंगे वो कैटाजन फेज में एंटर करेंगे, और कलेक्टिवली जो सेल्स है, फॉलिकल है, वो सब इनएक्टिव हो जाएंगे, और उसी के टाइम फॉलिकल होगा वो श्रिंक हो जाएगा, स्मॉलर हो जाएगा, और हेयर रूट से डीअटैच हो जाएगा वो. टिलोजन और द रेस्टिंग स्टेज, इवेंचुअली द सेल एंटर्स द टिलोजन फेज एंड द ग्रोथ साइकिल एंड्स. द टिलोजन stage is defined as a duration between the completion of follicular regression and the onset of the next anagen phase. मतलब follicular regression है तो वो catagen phase है, और onset of the next anagen phase, तो जैसे ही telogen phase मतलब hair पूरा shed off हो जाएगा, next anagen phase वहीं से start होगा. When another cycle begins, the follicle produces a new hair and the telogenic hair is pushed to the surface and shed. An adult average loses approximately about 80 to 100 hairs daily. Exogen phase or the shedding stage. Finally, strands are released from their follicles and fall out. Now, the whole process can begin. Each hair follicle is independent and goes through the growth cycle at different times. Otherwise, all your hair would fall out at once. Instead, you only shed a certain number of hairs a day, that is 80 to 100 hairs on a healthy head of hair. Hair loss, hair thinning, and problems with the hair growth may occur when your growth cycle is disrupted. This can be triggered by the conditions such as metabolic imbalances, illness or improper nutrition. But what hinders the hair growth? You might be wondering that if a hair growth works in a cycle, then why do we start facing hair loss? Well, as mentioned above, the anagen phase depends on the genetic and the health conditions. Due to several causes such as aging, hormonal changes, DHT, lack of proper nutrition, stress, and other factors, the anagen phase gets shorter and leads the follicle to shrink over time. The result in hair follicles producing shorter and thinner hair with each cycle and eventually stops producing altogether. This process is termed as miniaturization, and the entire condition is known as androgenic alopecia. In simple words, the shortening of anagen phase leads to thinner hair follicle and causes the visible hair loss. What can shorten your anagen phase? People who are on a calorie-restricted diet may shorten their anagen phase. This can also happen due to stress, childbirth, or any traumatic events. More hair follicles go into the telogen phase at the same time, and you can see diffuse hair loss, also termed as telogen effluvium. There are also be anagen effluvium from chemotherapies, radiation, or exposure to any toxic chemicals. This disrupts the hair while it is in the anagen phase. In these cases, the hair will usually recover to its prior fullness. Repeated bouts of dieting or chemotherapy would continue the pattern. There are rare cases of people who have short anagen syndrome, where they can never grow longer hair for reasons that are total count of the hair are almost about 50 lakhs. The scalp hair count is about 80,000 to 1.5 lakh. Hair cycle ratios of the scalp hair at different phases are 85 to 90% at anagen phase, 1% at catagen phase, and 10 to 15% at telogen phase. Duration of hair cycle in the different phases. In anagen phase, it durates for 2 to 6 years, in catagen 2 to 3 weeks, and in telogen phase, it stays for 3 months. Physiological hair shedding rate on the scalp is about 100 to 200 per day. Hair shaft production rate is 0.35 mm per day to 1 cm per month. Hair shaft pigmentation is about, in dark hair, predominance of eumelanin, and blonde or the red hair states the predominance of pheomelanin. Morphology of the hair. It includes the two part, which states first is the follicle with root and second is the shaft. Follicle with the root, it is the living part located under the skin. The root is the portion that anchors the hair to the skin. And shaft, it is fully keratinized non-living part above the skin surface, which consists of three parts, that is cuticle, cortex, and medulla. Cuticle, it is the outermost layer of the hair, which is heavily keratinized and shows a scale-like appearance. It consists of 5 to 15 overlapping layers of the dead and flattened and keratinized cell that protect the hair. It is externally seen as a series of uneven edges. It is also important protective properties and barrier function against the physical and chemical insults. The outer white layer, here we can see that terms the cuticle, or jo cuticle layer hai wo 5 to 15 overlapping layers at dead, flattened or keratinized cell ke jo hai na ek uneven appearance batata hai hair ke edges par, aur wo hume protect karega kiske against hai, to koi bhi physical ya chemical insults ke again hume protect karta hai. Cortex. The cortex comprises the bulk of the shaft and also contains melanin, which is responsible for the pigmentation or the color of the hair. It is the middle layer of hair consisting the pigment granules. In case of darkly colored, which are reduced in number or absent in gray-white hair. It has a fibrous appearance. Long strands of fiber run along the length of hair, interweaving so as to form such a great strength and elasticity. It is the main component of hair, containing long keratin chains that add elasticity, suppleness, and resistance to the hair. Medulla. The center or the core of the hair is termed as the medulla. which surrounds by the cortex. It is the innermost layer which may be absent in the thin hair. The hair medulla contains structural proteins that are markedly different from other hair keratins. Hair root. A papilla is located at the base of the hair root and contains nerves and capillaries that supply the nutrients. Here in the figure we can see the hair papilla which is located at the base. और वो क्या करता है तो जो भी हमारा हेयर है उसके लिए न्यूट्रिएंट्स सप्लाई करेगा एंड इट विल आल्सो कंटेन द नर्व्स एंड द कैपिलरीज. द पैपिला इज सराउंडेड बाय अ हेयर बल्ब दैट प्रोड्यूसेस द हेयर. द एक्सपेंडेड ओनियन शेप पोर्शन ऑफ द लोअर हेयर फॉलिकल इंक्लूडिंग द हेयर मैट्रिक्स एंड फॉलिकुलर पैपिला इज नोन एज द हेयर बल्ब विच इज द एक्टिव रिप्रोडक्टिव पोर्शन ऑफ द हेयर फॉलिकल. Biochemistry of the hair. It includes the hair is made up of 95% of keratin, a fibrous helicoidal protein that forms a part of the skin and also its appendages. Keratin is synthesized by keratinocytes and is insoluble in water, thus ensuring impermeability and protection for the hair. Some 18 amino acids are found in the hair such as proline, threonine, leucine and arginine. All these are the amino acids. Keratin is particularly rich in cysteine, a type of sulfurated amino acid which forms disulfide bond between the molecules, adding rigidity and resistance to the entire structure. Keratin may deform the styling. Keratin may be hard or the soft. Hard keratin is found in the hair and nails of the. Keratin is found in the epidermis of the skin in the form of flattened non-nucleated scales. The main difference in the various keratins arises from their sulfur content. If there are many cysteine disulfide crosslinks, then there is very little flexibility as in nails, horns or the claws. Alpha keratin, a fibrous, low sulfur contained keratin, is found in the greatest quantity in hair. Keratin proteins are divided into two major families, type 1 and type 2. Type 1 is the acidic keratin and type 2 is the basic or the neutral keratins. There are 11 type of 1 hair keratins designated as K31 to K40 and all 6 type 2 hair keratins designated K81 to K86, and the remainder are the epithelial keratins. Here is the chemistry of the curly hair, which says the here is the bond with the SS crosslink. It reduces to the curls and how the curly hair is formed. The hair cortex contains melanin, which is made up by a specialized cells named melanocytes situated near the hair bulb. The melanocytes inject the pigments into the keratinocytes of the new hair shaft. Melanin is insoluble in water and soluble in strong acids. Melanin diminishes with the age. Melanin is of two types: eumelanin, a dark color pigment or the black hair, and pheomelanin, it is a light color pigment, golden, brown or the red hair. Hair shaft pigmentation ensures multiple benefits including UV protection, thermal regulations and sexual perceptions. Other components of human hair include water, lipids mostly derived from sebum and made up of waxes, phospholipids, cholesterol, fatty acids, minerals that are the trace elements, iron, magnesium, zinc or copper. It contains basic elements such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and sulfur. Thank you.